Do you know what the buyer's journey is? Are you creating content for buyers at each stage of the buyer's journey? The buyer's journey is made up of three stages: the awareness stage, the consideration stage, and the conversion stage. The awareness stage is when the buyer understands that they have a problem, and then they go online and begin looking for solutions for that problem. The consideration stage is when the buyer finally understands the problem they have, and then begins looking for solutions online. And finally, the conversion stage, the stage most business owners are marketing for right now, is when the potential buyer understands the problem and the solutions, and they begin to narrow down to decide on one solution they want to go with. Traditional marketing tells us to put out an ad either through the newspaper or through the television, and then we sit around and hope it works. Ads in traditional marketing are typically focused on the sale or the service that you provide. And the idea is that the value for the customer will be delivered once they actually purchase your product or service. As marketing has evolved with digital platforms like Google and Facebook, researchers have begun to understand that buyers actually go through what we call a buyer's journey. This is a three-stage series where buyers go from trying to understand what their problem is to understanding what service or product they need to solve that problem. Today we're going to step into the shoes of Rachel. Rachel is a soon-to-be bride who is trying to trim off just a few more inches before her wedding day. She's been diligent, working out, running, trying to eat moderately. She decides to go online and Google search ways that she can lose more weight, trying to find out what she might be doing wrong. In the process, she stumbles upon a medical spa's website that has detailed articles on weight loss. She begins to read through the articles looking for tips and pointers on ways that she can lose that extra weight. Two things that we notice from this that are a big win for the medical spa is that Rachel set a clear goal that she wants to lose some extra weight. She knows that she has a problem, but she's not sure on how she's gonna get there. This medical spa has positioned themselves to put out a blog weekly, sharing tips and tricks for people in the awareness stage so they can do things themselves, but the copy is ultimately aimed to guide them into the consideration stage and then the conversion stage. So what can you take away from this for your business? And what are a few ways you can create content to meet people at the awareness stage? By putting out content that is focused on answering questions and solving problems, you can meet buyers where they are and help them understand which services they truly need as opposed to services that might not necessarily fix the problem they have. Educational blog posts are a great opportunity to update to your website frequently so you can answer these questions and give tips and tricks that might align with your business's core offering. Two things that we notice from this that are a big win for the medical spa is that Rachel set a clear goal that she wants to lose some extra weight. She knows that she has a problem, but she's not sure on how she's going to get there. This medical spa has positioned themselves to put out a blog weekly, sharing tips and tricks for people in the awareness stage so they can do things themselves, but the copy is ultimately aimed to guide them into the consideration stage and then the conversion stage. On your service and product pages for your company's website will also help to not only convert site visitors into the consideration and conversion stage, but it will help optimize your search engine results for people that are searching for those questions as opposed to the services that you provide. I do notice that people often rely on just a facts page to answer any questions that are pertinent to the business. We generally try to shy away from this and incorporate those questions within the content, the pages people are already looking at, and if there are any remaining questions after all of those are answered, we will create a facts page with quick, short answers. Educational videos and posts on social media are a big opportunity for many small businesses. To know what kind of content you need to put on social media, make a list of the products or services that your brand provides, and then take the time with your team to write down possible things people could face, problems or issues that would cause them to want to have your product or service. Let's say you offer a face treatment. It could be some type of acne they haven't had before. It could be dry skin. It could be rosacea. Once you have this list of possible problems or situations people are going through, create some easy at-home DIYs that they can do and follow along to. These educational videos will not only help your potential audience, but it will show the authority you have for the space and help them build trust in you before they even visit your facility. One big ongoing trend I've seen during COVID-19 and that a lot of businesses are taking advantage of is Facebook and Instagram live videos. Now, these could be videos where you are taking Q&A from your potential audience or from your existing customers. Or this could be live videos where you are interviewing authorities in your industry. Live videos like these can help educate your audience, and they also build that relationship and strengthen the connection you have with them. And lastly, industry updates. If your audience can be confident that you are the place to go to when they need news about new skin routines or new weight loss routines, then they will definitely take the time to like and follow your pages and keep up to date with your website content. By taking the time to understand the journey buyers go through, you can more effectively create marketing content that will reach them at the stage they're at and help further them along to the conversion stage. Want more help creating content ideas for each stage of the buyer's journey? Click the link in the description below and you can download our Crafting Your Message marketing template that will walk you through creating content for each stage of the buyer's journey. In the next video, we're going to join Rachel as she transfers from the awareness stage to the consideration stage, and she begins using the medical spa's blogs to understand the services that would best benefit her. To watch that and to understand what kind of content you can create in the consideration stage, click the video right here. I'll see you there.